What's up, my audio ducking aficionados? Today, I'm going to show all of my terrific PD peeps how to improve sound quality using volume keyframes for audio ducking with PowerDirector. If you're new to my channel and you want to learn how to use PowerDirector, click the subscribe button and click on the bell to get notifications every time I upload content to YouTube. Audio ducking is a tool that's used to make sure that your audience can hear what you want them to hear. It's usually used to raise and lower music so that the person who's speaking can be heard or you can hear other activities going on in the background. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to use audio ducking to make your audio top notch. Let's duck out of the way so that audio can play. As you can see, I have a video clip on the main track and some music on an audio track. This whole procedure is a lot easier to do when you can see the audio waveform of your main video. So let's go ahead and do something real quick. We're going to go to the media icon. We're going to make sure that we're on the video tab. Go to the location where the video is. Hold your finger on that video and then drag it down to one of the audio tracks and let it go. What that does is it adds just the audio to that track, and now we can see the waveform of the video track. So now you want to tap back and you want to tap back. Now, if you have a separate audio file like a voiceover, you can just go to that file and then add it to the audio track. Now we actually have audio coming from three sources, so it's best to mute the audio on the main track. So let's go ahead and tap on the video clip on the main track. We'll tap on audio mixing, and then we'll tap on mute, which mutes that track. Then we'll tap the line to close this out. Now that we can see the audio waveforms, we can use keyframes to adjust the music volume whenever the subject is talking. So we're going to go ahead and tap on the music. Then we'll tap on volume, and we're going to move our playhead to a position where we want the volume to begin decreasing. Then we'll go ahead and tap on add a keyframe. Now we're going to move our playhead to a position where we want the volume to stop decreasing. And we'll move our slider to the position that we want. We're going to move it down to about 50. And it'll go ahead and add a keyframe right at that position. Next, you want to move your playhead to a position where you want the volume to start increasing, so the music is going back up. So I'm using the waveform at the bottom for the speech, so I know where I want to stop this at. And at this point, I'm going to just hold my finger on the keyframe button and let it go. And I'm going to select duplicate previous keyframe. That'll keep the volume the same all the way through while the individual is speaking. Now you want to move your playhead to a position where you want the volume to stop increasing. And then you want to move your slider back up to 100 or whatever volume you want. And it'll add a keyframe right there. And now you can see that where the waveform shows the speech on the second audio track, the volume is lower. It actually fades down, goes lower, and then goes back up to continue being at the regular volume after the speech has stopped. Now all you really need to do is continue this process each time you want the subject's audio to be louder than the music. So let's play this back and give this ducked audio a listen. Audio ducking is a tool that's used to make sure that your audience can hear what you want them to hear. That ain't nothing to quack at. If you like what you see, I'll leave some links to buy PowerDirector in the video description. I know you want more PowerDirector love, so be sure to click on these videos to watch more of my content and smash my logo to subscribe. Don't forget to drop me a comment and a like down below.